The most powerful man in the world, Monday night at 9.
Did Vladimir Putin use his power to elect Donald Trump? That's the question behind our new CNN special report, The Most Powerful Man in the World. Fareed Zakaria hosts, and he is back with me now. I can't wait to see this. It's going to be fascinating. You interviewed Dmitry Peskov, right? He is a top aide and a longtime spokesman for Russian President Vladimir Putin. And you wasted no time. You asked him about the Trump associates meeting with the Russian ambassador, Sergei Kislyak. Listen.
So what was it that the Russian ambassador, Sergei Kislyak, was talking to so many of Donald Trump's associates about?
This is his job. He was talking about bilateral relations. He was talking about what is going on in the United States, so we have a better understanding in Moscow. This is what is being performed by every ambassador of Russia abroad, every ambassador of the United States abroad, including in Moscow. Because the more ambassador talks to people in his country of residence, the better job he does.
Did he have similar meetings with Clinton campaign officials? Because I don't know of any.
Well, if you look at some people connected with Hillary Clinton during her campaign, you would probably see that he had lots of meetings of that kind. But there were no meetings about electoral process. There was in no way it should be percepted as interference in electoral process.
Do you believe him when he said there was no interference in the electoral process or the election process?
Look, it's sort of at some level beyond my pay grade, but what I can tell you is there are 17 American intelligence agencies. They rarely agree on anything. They did not agree, for example, on whether Iraq had weapons of mass destruction. They did not agree on the size of the Soviet economy. 17 American intelligence agencies all agree with high confidence that Russia tried to affect the outcome of the American election. And they issued a joint document which said, A, Putin personally ordered it. B, he did it because of the reason you mentioned in the last segment, which is that he believed that Hillary Clinton had tried to stop his return to power. Remember, there was a period where he was prime minister trying to come back as president, and Hillary came out in favor of Russian demonstrations at the time.
I have 30 seconds left here, and I hate to give you short shrift, but what can we expect Monday night with this Putin special? It couldn't come at a more timely manner.
Unbelievable program that everyone should watch. Well, I think what we really try to explain is, who is Putin and what is he after? You know, we've spent all this time talking about Putin-Trump, but what is Putin trying to get at? What is his goal?
What's interesting to me is that President Trump should be the most powerful man in the world. But because of his actions towards Putin, he's made Putin the most powerful man in the world.
I think that's true, and yeah. I think that it probably... I imagine the title of this documentary will give him no pleasure. But, of course, he doesn't watch CNN.
Yeah. He'll be watching Monday night, trust. Thank you, Fareed Zakaria. I appreciate that. You can see Fareed Zakaria GPS Sunday, 10 a.m. and 1 p.m. Eastern. Plus, Fareed explores the relationship between Donald Trump and Vladimir Putin in the new CNN special report, The Most Powerful Man in the World. We're talking about Vladimir Putin. That's Monday night at 9.